Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class, we were doing the chapter Fun with Numbers, correct? So what did we do in the chapter Fun with Numbers? We learned what are even numbers, we learned what are odd numbers, then we studied how to compare given numbers that is greater than or less than. Then we saw what are ascending order, what is descending order. Correct. We also saw what are cardinal numbers and ordinal numbers. So cardinal numbers are nothing but your regular numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Ordinal numbers represent a position. Correct. So 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th. These are all ordinal numbers. Right. So this is what we learned in the chapter Fun with Numbers. So in today's class, we'll start with the new chapter that is called Whole and Parts. So what do you mean by whole and parts? So a whole is nothing but when you have a complete object. For example, if you take a pizza, the entire pizza is a whole, correct? It's a whole pizza. But when you start making slices and taking one and eating, they become parts. So if you take one slice out of a pizza, that is one part of the whole pizza. Okay, so any part of a whole are called as fractions. Okay, they are called as fractions. Then let's see what are equal parts or halves. So now, for example, there is a chocolate and you want to divide it equally between you and your friend. So what will do? You will cut that chocolate into two halves, correct? So here we have a chocolate bar. It has 8 pieces. Now for both you and your friend to get equal number of chocolates, what you'll do, you'll divide it into halves. So you will get 4 pieces, your friend will get 4 pieces, right? So 4 and 4, so that is half and half. So that is nothing but equal parts. So into two equal parts called half. And how do you write half? You write half like this. 1 by 2. Okay, this is how you write half. Alright, this represents half. So one half of something means one part of two equal parts of that thing. So here we divided this chocolate into two equal parts. So one part of these two equal parts will be one half. Okay, so this part will be one half of that chocolate. Alright, so this is the meaning of half. Okay, so here now we have a square. Now this square, they have divided into two equal parts. This is one and this is two. So this is one half. Okay, now what about this rectangle? If you see, this part which is white or which is not shaded is not equal to the pink color part, right? So this is not equal. It's not divided into two equal parts. So this is not a half. Okay, same with this heart. Now if you see this heart, it is divided equally. So this is one part, the green color is one part and the white is one part. So they are divided into two equal parts and the green color, if I take, that will be one half of that heart. Same if you see this heart now. Now the one, the shaded orange part is very smaller than the white part, correct? So they are not equally cut or distributed. So this is not half. Same way with this square now. This square, there's a yellow part and this white part. Is the yellow equal to the white? No, it is not. So this is also not one half. And what about this rectangle here? Now this rectangle has two triangles. One, two. So one is a blue and one is a white part. Now both of these are equal. So this blue is one half of this rectangle. Okay, this is one half. Now same way if I take an orange and I cut it into two parts. Okay, so one part, one equal part of that orange will be half of an orange and the other part will be another half of an orange. So if both the halves together make one whole orange. Okay, so this is a circle. Now I'll divide this circle into two equal parts. So this pink one is one half and the green is another half. Okay. Then when you fill a glass half up till middle, so that is half full. Okay, and this is one half of a watermelon. So other half you have eaten, and there is remaining watermelon. So that is one half of the watermelon. All right, then we have a circle here. So one half of the circle is green, and here one half of the rectangle is red, correct? One half of the rectangle is red, one half of the rectangle is yellow. Then one half of the stars are gold. Now here we have two stars, in that one star is gold. So this is one half of the stars are gold. Correct? So you write half like this, 1/2. So one part out of two equal parts is called as a half. So I hope you'll have understood what is a half. Okay. Now we'll see what is quarter or 1/4. So what is quarter? Now when you divide something into four equal parts, in that four equal parts, one part is called as 1/4, or each part is called as 1/4. Now pizza. If I divide the pizza into four equal parts, and one part is taken away, and you eat that one part, so the one part which you have eaten is a quarter of a pizza. Okay, that is a quarter of a pizza. So when we divide something into four equal parts, we cut it into quarters. Okay, a quarter means one part of four equal parts. So we write it like this, 1/4. Okay, so 1/4. So this is 1/4. A quarter means, what does a quarter mean? A quarter means one part of four equal parts. Okay, so here now there's a square. Now this square is divided into four equal parts, and the brown shaded part is 1/4, that is 1/4. Here in this circle is divided into four parts, and the blue shaded part is 1/4. Same with this shape, also is divided into four parts, and the green part is the quarter. Okay, this kite is divided into four parts now, and the yellow color shaded part is 1/4 or a quarter. Now this double-sided arrow is also divided into four equal parts, and the red shaded part is 1/4 of that arrow mark. And the star again is divided into four parts, and this pink shaded part is 1/4 of the star, or 1/4 of a star. Okay, so this is a whole, that is an entire thing. Okay, so if I take this entire circle together, it is a whole, that is one. And then if I cut this circle into two parts, so this will be one half and this will be another half. And if I cut this circle further into four equal parts, so these all each are 1/4. So this is 1/4, this is another quarter, this is 1/4, and this is another quarter. Okay, so there are four quarters in a circle. Okay, or how many ever if you divide. So if you divide a circle into four parts, it will have four quarters. All right, so this is whole, half, and quarter. Now see this watermelon. Now this watermelon is divided into two equal parts, so each part is one half. Further, if you divide this watermelon into four equal parts, so each part is a quarter or 1/4. Okay, it is read as 1/4 or a quarter. All right, so this is all about wholes and parts. Okay, so here, page number 131 in your books. So whole and parts, so equal parts half. So if we cut an apple into two equal parts, we say that we have cut it in half. So one half means one part out of two equal parts. Okay, so one half means one part out of two equal parts. Now we write half as 1/2. So this is a half plus a half. So two halves together make a whole. Okay, so we write half as 1/2. So here they've told tick the shapes that are cut in half. So let's tick the shapes that are cut in half. Now is this cut in half? Yes. Yes, we have two equal green parts here. So this is cut in half. Now what about this circle? It's only one small part. It is not two equal parts, correct? So this is not. So you can either leave it blank or you can put a cross mark there. So we'll leave it blank. So this is a tick mark. Then this pipe, is it cut into equal parts? Yes. So it's cut into half. What about this triangle here? This is also cut in half. So we'll put a tick mark. Now what about this pipe? This one is smaller than this one, correct? So we'll leave it blank. It is not half. And what about this? It is not half. This is smaller than this. So this is not a half. So first one, third one, and fourth one are cut in half. Okay. Then give a different color to each half, right? 1/2 in each part. Okay. So we have to color them. Okay. We have to color them into different colors and write 1/2 in each part. So let's do that now. So here they have written 1/2 and 1/2. So we'll color them. So if I color the first half red. Okay, so you have to color both the halves different color. You can color one part red, one part yellow, or any other color. You can color any colors you want, but they should be two different colors. Okay, so this is first one. Now let's do the second one. So I'll color the first one, first part blue. Okay, first part is blue. Then I'll color the second part dark blue. Okay, so this is dark blue. And just write 1/2 over there. You have to write 1/2 inside, like how they have written here. You have to write that. I can't write it because I've colored on it, but you all write it in your books. Okay, then this circle. So I'll color it green now. So I'll color one half green. Okay, we'll color one half green color. We'll make sure that the color doesn't come out of the line. Okay, and I'll color the other dark green. Okay, then this shape. So we'll color it gray. And black. Okay, we'll color the other half black. Make sure one color doesn't go into the other half. Okay, then this triangle. Now, same way, you have to color two different halves in two different shapes or two different colors. Okay, so this triangle is very easy. So I'll leave that for you to do. So here this will be one half of this shape. Okay, and the rest is another half. So you all can color that in some other color. Same here, this H. This is one color, one half. And the rest is another half. So you all can color whichever color you want. Okay. Now same way here, they've told all the following shapes have been cut into four equal parts. So do the remaining for homework. Now write 1/4 in each part. One has been done for you. Okay, so they've told all the following shapes have been cut into four equal parts. So they've told write 1/4 in each part. So one has been done. So let's write 1/4 in each of the parts. So, like how first one is done, second one also needs to be done. So, this is 1/4, correct? And this will be 1/4. That is 1/4. Like here also, 1/4. Right? And this also, 1/4. Now, so we wrote 1/4 in each quarter. Now here also in this circle also you can write the same way. 1/4. Then again 1/4. This is 1/4, and this is also 1/4. All right. So now again here also same thing, 1/4, a quarter, and here also 1/4. So like this. So 1/4 and 1/4. So this should come within the square. All right. So the same way do the last four also. Just write 1/4 in each part. Next, color the shapes that are cut in squares. So you need to color the shapes which are cut in squares here. So which are the shapes which are cut in squares? The first one is done, right? So color all the squares in this one. So let's do that. So I'll color all the squares here. Okay. So here, next one, the triangle. Is it cut in squares? It is not. So let's not color that. And what about this one? Is there a square here? There are two squares. So you can color those two squares. Actually, it is not a square, it's a rectangle. So we'll leave that. It looks more like a rectangle. Okay. Then what about this circle? There's no square here. Are there squares here? No, there's a triangle. And then these are also not squares. What about this? This is also not square. Now here in this one square is there. So we'll color that one square. So rest of the shapes are not cut into. Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. You need to color the shapes that are cut into quarters, not squares. Okay, you need to color the shapes that are cut into quarters. So this is cut into a quarter. So we'll color this. Quarter means four equal parts, right? So this is cut into four equal parts. So we'll color this now. This is cut into four equal parts, four parts, but they are not equal, so we'll not color. Same here, they are not, all four parts are not equal. Same with this one, again, all four parts are not equal, so we'll not color. Now here in this shape, all the four parts are cut in equal parts, so we'll color this. Okay, we'll color this shape. You can use other color also if you want, other than red. Okay. Now this circle is cut into three parts, so it is not quarters. Now this circle is cut into four equal parts, so we'll color it, okay? All right, so these three shapes you have to color, the square, this one, and this circle. All right, so you have to color the shapes that are cut into quarters. Okay, so this was that question, and now coming on to the last question over here. They have told write 1/2 or 1/4 to say how much in each of the following figure is colored. So here, out of four parts, one is colored, so that is 1/4. Now here, one they have done for you. It is half is colored, so 1/2. Now in this shape also half is colored, so this also will be 1/2. Now in this, four equal parts are there, in that one is colored, so 1/4. And in this one, again four equal parts are there, in which one is colored, so 1/4 again. Now here, two equal parts are there, in which one is colored, so it is a half. So, half. Okay, so this was all about holes and parts. Okay, so here, these four and these four you have to do for homework. So do that for your homework and we'll continue in the next class. All right, thank you students. I'll see you all in the next class.